here's what we're going to do, boys and girls. We're going to take our science. This is going to be for our science vocab. And we're going to take it and we're going to glue it into the first page of our yellow science spiral. And you're going to take it. And I'm going to show you what you're going to do with it. You're going to take your spiral and you're going to glue it very neatly. So the top of this page is going to be glued. So the top of it is hitting the blue line of the first page or the first line in the spiral. And then the side, this margin is going to be lined up with the red line. So it looks like this. Just like this. Are we seeing how that's lined up? Neatly like this. So it looks like this. Okay? So line it up and glue it in there. Don't over glue it because you're going to be writing on it. So don't over glue it so you can get it written on. Okay, everybody got that in there? Don't overdo it, but make sure all the sides are down. You don't need too much. It's got to stay in there, okay? That part at the top where it's all white. You see at the top where it's all white? Good. Now you can put your cap on your glue stick and you can put that in your desk along with your scissors. So you can put that away so it's in a nice safe place. Very good. Very nice. Now you can sit up so you're ready to pay attention because we are going to be working on our vocab. And I want you to title your page. Your page is going to be titled. And our new unit that we're going to be talking about is something called force and motion. So at the top in the white, at the top of your heading or the top of your page, we're going to call it force, F-O-R-C-E. And we can make the and sign if you want, force and motion. Okay, force and motion. Force and motion. Does everybody have that? Very, very good. Now, boys and girls, here's what we have. I want you now you have three boxes there. You have one that says draw a picture. You have a space for a vocabulary word. And then you have the definition. You see those three boxes? Here's how we're gonna do it. I'm going to tell you the word. We're gonna write the word. Then I'm gonna tell you the definition. And I'm gonna write the definition. Do not write anything until I've written it all out so you can see how much you have to write. So then you can see how big your writing has to be. You ready? And then I'm gonna draw the picture and you're gonna draw the same picture that I'm going to draw. So our first word in force and motion is going to be the word force. So we've got our paper. It's going to be divided into three. I'm going to kind of erase this because I'm going to need all the room I can muster here. So let me do that. So here we're going to have our paper is kind of divided. So here we're going to have our picture area. This is kind of a lot for, this is going to be my picture. Use that. Okay. And then I'm going to have my word right here. And our first word, this is where our picture is going to be. This is our picture area. Okay, picture. And then right here is going to be our vocab word, where the vocab is. And then we're going to have a section where we have our definition. Where we define our word. We have all of our important information about our words. So our first word, and that goes in the middle column, is the word force. Force. F-O-R-C-E. Everybody write the word force in the middle column. Middle column. Middle. And force, I'm going to tell you the definition, don't write anything yet, is a push or a pull that causes an object to move, stop, or change direction. That's what force is. Force is a push or pull that causes an object to move, stop, or change direction. Do not write anything until after I'm done writing it, so you know. So it is a push or pull that causes an object to stop or change. Sorry, boys and girls, got erased. That's why we have erasers. I forgot move. To move, stop, or change direction. That's what a force is. So let's write that. Okay, now, a push or pull that causes an object to move, stop, or change direction. Now, here's going to be our picture. We are going to draw, and this is my picture. Now, obviously I'm not a great artist, but I'm going to try my best. This is somebody. Oh, I don't like how I did that. I'm going to adjust that a little bit. Make a little space here on it. this is a person doing what? They are kicking the ball. And so this is kick the ball. Somebody kicking the ball. That's their foot kicking the ball. Now here's word number two. We have the word movement. M-O-V-E-M-E-N-T. And a movement is a change of position or location. A change of movement or a change of position or location. A change of position or location. Okay, so that is movement. That is movement, a change of position or location. And here is my example of movement. Now here I'm going to draw, this is a hill. Oh. That's a hill. And on top of my hill, right here, I am drawing a car. Drawing a car. That's a car tire. And here is my car. Okay? There's my car. I have some limitations here on drawing on this board. And that is the start of my car. My car is going down the hill, right, boys and girls? And this is where my car is going to do what? It is going to stop. My car. Starts and then it stops. That is movement. Okay, we have movement. Our next word is the word gravity. Gravity. G-R-A-V-I-T-Y. Gravity. And gravity is a force that pulls objects towards the center of the earth. A force that pulls objects. That pulls objects towards the center of the earth. Okay, that is gravity. A force that pulls objects toward the center of the earth. And my picture is going to be a picture of making the earth. I want some arrows here. I'm going to draw a nice into the center of the earth. Okay? Where's your arrow? Okay, is everybody ready? Can I move on to the next word? Yes, everybody ready? Definition. Okay. So who's heard all these words already before? You've heard a lot of these words before. Who's known all the definitions already? Oh, you've known all the definitions? Awesome. Okay, I think maybe I'm going to come up with a word you may not know already, pretty soon. Now we have a word called friction. F-R-I-C-T-I-O-N. Friction. Who knows what friction is? What is friction? What's friction? Can't hear you at all. Oh, okay. Friction. Friction is a force. Don't write anything, just write the word. Friction is a force that slows or stops motion when objects rub together. So friction is a force that slows down or stops. Slows down or stops. An object. When they rub together. Or when objects rub. Or stops when objects when objects rub together. That slows down or stops motion when objects rub together. Motion when objects rub together. Objects rub together. Okay, there. Got it there. Sorry, boys and girls. So a force that slows down or stops motion when objects rub together. And here is our picture. Ball is rolling. Ball rolling. Okay, the ball is rolling. But this is rough. So the rough of the grass is going to slow down the ball. If you've ever played softball or baseball or done golf, the grass is going to slow down the ball because it is rough. I'm even going to make a little more grass. Okay? That's going to slow the whole ball down because that is rough. Our next word is the word, okay, I don't know if you've ever heard this word. Are you ready? Oh, it's people, are still people still writing and drawing? Give you a second. Inertia. You've heard the word inertia before. I see puzzle looks. Okay, so here's our new word, inertia. I-N-E-R-T-I-A, inertia. Okay. Oh, that's a funny word. Okay, so I-N-E-R-T-I-A. So inertia is the property of an object that resists movement by force. So it's the property of an object that resists movement by a force. So let's write that. The property of an object that resists movement by force. And here is my example. This is a box. And it stays put. Box just stays put. It's not not going anywhere. That box isn't going anywhere. That box is just staying put there. We're going to learn more about inertia. And our last word is a very scientific word, and it is a unit of measurement called a newton. Okay? A newton. And a newton is the standard international unit of force named after Sir Isaac Newton. So the standard international unit of force named after tree. Even though those aren't looking very apple-y. And then I'm going to draw a person sitting on the ground. They're getting clocked on the head with an apple. Because he came up with gravity by watching an apple hit somebody in the head. So I'm sure you could do a much better job of somebody getting hit in the head with an apple from an apple tree. Because I'm going to tell you this much, this thing is not very good for drawing. I draw a picture of somebody getting hit in the head with an apple from an apple tree. Yes. Well, hurry up. Did you finish drawing?
Yes.
Then you can go. So that is our vocabulary that we're going to need for what we're doing right now. And we have the words force, movement, gravity, friction, inertia, and Newton. Those are our words.